Hello everybody and welcome to video number 29 of the online version of the Fusion Research Lecture. We are in chapter 5, collisional transport, and in the last video we talked about stellarator specific elements for neoclassical transport and about the diffusion coefficient in a stellarator. And in this video we will just briefly talk a little bit about the ambipolar electric field. So the that should be a bit thicker. Maybe like that. The ambipolar electric field. Topic of this video. So, to give a mathematically rigorous and correct derivation of the transport coefficients, we need, as I initially said, a kinetic description. So, to be mathematically correct, a kinetic description is required to derive the full particle flux and thus the transport. And if one would do such a full treatment, one would get for the particle flux an expression like the following. So R for radial and then electron and ion, having the density, then the diffusion coefficient as we had derived it. So this is the diffusion coefficient for the transport processes we discussed. Then the density gradient over the density. So this is a radial derivative. Then the charge number of the particle species over the charge for the electron, where this E looks a bit weird, like that. Then the radial electric field over the temperature of electrons or ions. Then a term including the thermodiffusion. So here's, a diffusion coefficient for the thermodiffusion for electron or ion, meaning we have an expression here where we have the electron or ion temperature gradient, the radial derivative of it, electron ion. And finally, an expression where we have a diffusion due to the wear pinch, meaning the toroidal electric field is included here. So as I said, this basically corresponds to the diffusion coefficient we discussed over the last videos. This is due to the diffusion coefficient. This expression here is due to the, this is called the thermodiffusion due to the temperature gradient, which is the cause of that. And this one here is, as we discussed, the wear pinch. This is the wear pinch. Okay, in the last videos, you hopefully have realized that radial fluxes, so radial transport processes, radial fluxes are not necessarily ambipolar, especially when it comes to the transport of helically trapped particles. We've seen that these are not ambipolar to start with. The ambipolarity, which we find in lead, is achieved by a radial electric field. So the ambipolarity is achieved by the ambipolar electric field. And we get that from the equations which we just had by setting the electron flux to be the same as the ion flux. And the resulting electric field to get that is called the ambipolar electric field, the ambipolar radial electric field. Now, the calculation of the diffusion coefficient for the electron in ion flux in a fully kinetic description is actually quite complex. So the calculation of the diffusion coefficient in the expressions for the particle flux for electrons and ions in a fully kinetic description is quite complex. And this is why there are numerical codes for that. And a famous one example is the DKESS code, which stands for drift kinetic equation solver. Now let's finally have a look at an example. So here you see DKESS calculations for W7AS. So this is W7AS, where we have assumed density and ion temperature profiles to be constant, so not changing. This is one radial position, so this is a fixed radial position. But the electron temperature has varied. So the electron temperature has been varied from figure to figure. So on the left hand side, it's an electron temperature of 500 eV, in the center 2 keV, and on the rightmost figure 4 keV. Now, what do we see here? Let's have a look. Let's first have a look at the ions. So the ions correspond here to the dashed line. So here you see the ions, the radial transport profile of the ions, which of course is the same in every figure because the ion temperature does not change. And you see there is a central peak, and the central peak is due to the direct losses of helically trapped particles. And we always have some collisionless particles in the Maxwellian tail, which are directly lost if they are helically trapped. Then there are secondary peaks. So left and right, secondary peaks. And the secondary peaks are due to the toroidal resonance. Now you might wonder why there are two secondary peaks, because the electric field can point in either inwards or outwards. So it's the sign of the electric field which leads to two peaks here. And then there is the solution, the radial transport as a function of the wave of the radial electric field for the electrons shown, which is the solid line. The solid black line, so this one here in each of the pictures. And as the electron temperature has been varied, this profile changes from graph to graph. However, the general structure for the electrons is similar to the ions. Similar to ions, but it has a different scale. And what often can be neglected is the toroidal resonance. This plays in principle no role for the electrons. Toroidal resonance can be neglected. Okay, if we look again at this drawing, we see there are these graphs. We see there are intersection points. Here, for example, or here, here's an intersection point, and somewhere on the right, maybe somewhere here, if we extend this, would be an intersection point as well. And the intersection points of both curves, so the intersection points of both curves, these are the stable solutions we have. These are the stable solutions for the ambipolar radial electric field. So only if we have a radial electric field of this order, then we have a stable solution. Okay. So there are a few comments for the stable solutions. So we get a more decreasing radial electric field if we have dominant ion flux, as indicated on the left hand side. You see the stable solution is in more onto the negative radial electric fields, so we get further decreasing radial electric fields for dominant ion fluxes. For dominant ion fluxes. And this is the region which we already introduced as ion root, or regime which we introduced as ion root. And we get an increasing radial electric field if we have dominant electron flux. And this regime was called, was introduced in the last video as being called the electron root. Okay. Now, looking at the examples here, in the first case, we have the electron temperature. We have an electron temperature of 500 eV corresponding to the ion temperature. And in this scenario, we have an ion root regime. And this is basically the normal case for a fusion plasma. So this is a normal case for a fusion plasma. If we have decreased electron density and strong electron heating, then we can get higher electron fluxes initially than ion fluxes. And the increased losses would be mostly due to collision-less transport. So helically losses of helically trapped particles. And the two examples shown above, on the middle and on the right, on the very right hand side first, we have an electron temperature of 4 keV, so 4000 electron volt. And there we are in the electron root regime, and we have a very large positive radial electric field needed for getting finally ambipolar transport. And in the interesting case is maybe more in the center, where we have 2 keV, 2000 electron volt, because there are multiple routes possible. As you can see in the picture, multiple routes are possible. So there are more than one stable, there's more than one stable solution. And what actually can happen, the sudden jumps between, or sudden jumps of the radial electric field is possible. So jumping from one stable solution to the other stable solution. And this is actually what also happens in the experiment, what is observed in the experiment, these sudden jumps. Observed, not too much of a difficult word. Okay, that was just a final example of electron and ion transport in shown at the W7AS decelerator. And that's basically it for the video, where I just wanted to show you or make a few comments about the ambipolar electric field and show an example of W7AS, and that there are multiple solutions sometimes possible for getting a stable plasma, a stable situation, and that the radial electric field can jump between these kind of solutions. That's it for the video. Hope to see you in the next.